Welcome to the Know Before You Go Travel Show, where we share all the latest travel tips, tricks, and insights to make your next vacation the best one yet. So sit back, relax, grab a cocktail, and enjoy the show with Peniak Travel's George Peniak and our senior travel consultant, Janet Peniak.
What is up, everybody?
Hey, everyone.
Welcome back to another edition of the Know Before You Go Travel Show, and we've got a show for you today.
Back from Jamaica, Mom.
Back from Jamaica, Mon, and we have the Jamaican hangover, vacation hangover, Mon.
Yeah.
And it's hump day.
You know, it's always rough like that, the first few days when you get back from vacation, just because it's like, usually, you know, when you travel, you get home kind of late, and then you, if you have to go to work the next day, and you've got a lot of unpacking to do and laundry, and then your work's piled up, and it's just, yeah, it's been a week so far.
Stop complaining.
Oh, I know.
I bet every.
I know. Please cry me a river.
Yeah, cry me a river, babe.
I'm going to shut up now.
I'm just tired because it's hump day. These hump days, yeah, it's, you know, just getting through the week here.
Yeah, but we had a great time.
We had a great time, and we are back, and we're drinking our seltzer water here. Give me a little cheers on this, which you got there, polar. I got me raspberry lime. You got a cran. What's that?
Cranberry lime.
Cranberry lime. That sounds good.
Yeah, the polar ice seltzers.
But we are back. It is Wednesday. It does feel good to be back in the studio. Last podcast, we did the mobile studio, which isn't quite as comfortable as our big roomy studio that we have.
Yes.
It's nice.
And that was live. Yeah, that was live from Montego Bay.
I enjoy doing that.
Yeah, it's fun.
I like taking the show with us, and then we can do it on the road anywhere we go. And that was really cool. And I thought the room was very accommodating for it. It wasn't like what we have here, big wide open studio, but it was very comfortable.
Yes. No, yeah. It definitely was.
Yeah.
So we are back though.
We are back and it feels good.
So the weather was perfect in Jamaica, by the way. This is a great time of year to go if you're looking to, you know, get out of the cold and go somewhere warm. It was like 82 degrees and sunny every single day. It never rained. It was perfect, perfect weather.
This is probably one of the first trips we went on where it didn't rain.
Yeah.
At all. And it that was really nice. That was good. Did not rain. Felt really good. But we're back and it's raining here.
Yeah, it is raining here.
Slightly colder, but it's all good.
Yes.
We mush on.
We do have a full review coming soon of our, which I think we've reviewed it in the past, but of our most recent stay at Sandals Montego Bay. But if you are familiar with the two, or if you're not, Sandals Montego Bay and then Sandals Royal Caribbean, which is also in Montego Bay, they share exchange privileges with each other. And there's a complimentary shuttle that runs between the two every hour. And you can utilize, you know, all of the services, restaurants, entertainment, everything, no matter which one you're staying at. And so we went over to Royal Caribbean for the day, and they have done a ton of updates since the last time we were there. The last time we stayed there was 2015. So it's been almost 6 years, and they've done a lot of updates since then. And I have a renewed love for this resort.
Yeah, that is a great way to put it. I have a massively renewed love. I've always liked it and appreciated it. And
yes.
We always talk about like our rankings and, you know, a lot of these, we get asked a lot what our rankings are.
Yeah. And it fluctuates kind of.
It's hard to like, cause
it all depends on like what mood I'm in.
Yeah. It's like
what I'm looking for.
Yeah. What am I looking for? And I mean, it's really hard to do an overall ranking. I think I probably could sit down one day and look at everything. And
I mean, sometimes I have a ranking in my head, and then sometimes I'm like, well, if I don't want to go to Mexico, then that's not my ranking. Or if I don't want all that long of travel, then that's not my ranking. So it kind of just depends.
Yeah, there's a lot of variables in there. And then also, too, do you compare the destination and the resort, or do you just compare resort to resort?
Right.
And that's where it gets really tricky. I think I can compare resort to resort. But when you start mixing in the destinations, because certain destinations are a lot more exotic than others, then I'm like, okay, I have an amazing resort here in a destination that, you know, don't get me wrong, any destination's great, but it's not like, it's kind of like comparing like maybe a Cancun to like a Grenada or something,
right?
Or Barbados,
right?
You know, or Zuma, Bahamas. It's really hard to make those comparisons, but it's easier to just do straight up resort to resort.
Yes, yeah.
And if I think about Royal Caribbean, which we're going to talk about Royal Caribbean a lot today, by the way. I think this is going to be the theme of the show here.
I thought that was what we agreed to before we started this.
Yeah, that's what we did. We're going to go with that.
I'm like, what are you changing?
And it, you know, to be honest, going into it, just going off the 2015, I thought it was a fine resort. I was like, this is a very good resort. It delivers a lot. And, you know, but after this, I'm like, okay, it skyrocketed in my rankings. I mean, it shot way up in the rankings.
Yeah.
Highest moving resort I think I've ever seen in my own rankings from like just a few years ago to today.
Yeah.
And it impressed me. I'll be honest, the thing that wowed me the most, and you can probably go ahead and say it because I'd never seen them with my own eyes. You've stayed in them before. I've never stayed in
them. Yeah, the Overwater Bungalows.
Yeah, that is something to see. That's a sight to see alone with your own eyes.
Yes, which they do. They have those at Sandals Royal Caribbean. And so that resort, they have a private island. And it's about, what, like a 5 to 7 minute boat ride across the bay. It's short.
Maybe 5 minutes.
Yeah, maybe five minutes. Very short, which they've actually updated. Not only have they updated a lot of the resort, they also updated their boat that goes from the island and back. But anyways, so you're on a private island over there, and they have overwater bungalows over there, plus two restaurants, a swim-up bar. I don't know. I guess I just kind of forgot what it was like to be over there. But George that was the first time he had ever seen an overwater bungalow in person.
In person, yeah.
And I have toured actually those before 2 years ago. And I mean, they're fabulous. And I think seeing it and then like you're out there on the island, it just really makes you feel like you're in this super exotic destination.
Oh, yeah, it does. It does. And that private island, which by the way, so if you can go to that private island without staying in the overwater bungalows.
Yes.
Everyone has access to it.
And if you're staying at Sandals Montego Bay, you also have full access. You can go out there.
Yeah, which is what we did.
Yes.
And that was the first thing we did. We got on property. So we take the 5 minute transfer. It's a real short transfer. Like the properties are almost right next to each other. And we get off. And I got the camera rolling. I got a full resort tour, which I'll post soon. And we checked out. We like breezed through some of the restaurants, like the French restaurant there. Yeah. Popped our head into Cricketers, and then you pop right around the corner of Cricketers, and wow, there it is. Boom. You see the overwater bungalows. You know, it's probably like, I don't know, probably a quarter mile off. It's not far. It's a couple hundred yards. And I was like, holy smokes.
Yes.
We're going over there. And
yeah, George, like, we're going over there right now.
We're going over there right now. I just want to focus on that right now.
Yeah.
And I knew they had a swim-up bar and a pool and a restaurant.
Yes, we enjoyed all of that when we stayed there previously.
Yes, and so this private island has access to your overwater bungalows if you're staying in one. It has a swim-up pool, swim-up bar, pool, hot tub. Has a neat little beach. It's not the biggest beach, but it's a quiet beach.
Yeah, but it's beautiful.
Kind of in that little bay area.
Yeah, and I love
call it.
It
a bay, but you know.
Well, one thing I want to mention really quick about the beach here, because I really like the beach. Yeah, it's not that big, but I love it. It's so beautiful because it looks back on the island of Jamaica. And so you have like, you know, the crystal clear blue water with the big mountains, and it's really nice.
Yeah, and the water's super calm. It's super
calm.
You can walk right out into it. It's very shallow.
Yeah.
I think you won't get much more than probably like maybe chest deep, waist deep.
Yeah.
As you're walking over, they have a gazebo type thing that's in the water.
Yeah.
That you can climb onto and sit down.
Be careful if you've had too much rum punch or you might fall.
I fell. I thought I was going to break my tailbone or something or tear my shoulder. Like I fell while I was recording.
George was actually recording him walking down into the water from it and he slipped and fell and it was freaking hilarious because he busted his butt so bad and he caught it on video and we can't unfortunately post it because there's some curse words, but it's really funny.
Yeah, well, you know, I'm not clumsy. I never fall.
I know.
And I'm just walking down, and I was actually filming my feet walking into the crystal clear water off the gazebo, and it's only like 4 steps. Like,
right.
It's not very far. And I guess there's like algae on the step or something.
Yeah, it was slippery.
I just obviously did not have my hand on the rail. I'm holding my phone looking down.
Yeah.
And I just ate it.
Yeah.
And I thought I just cracked a tailbone. But I'm fine. Bounced right up. A few cuss words later. But it's a hilarious video.
Yeah, you probably didn't feel too much of it either because you had like 10 rum punches that day.
I had way too much rum punch.
Yeah.
When we got back to Montego Bay, I literally had to drink coffee before dinner, which I don't like having caffeine late in the day.
Yeah.
And I'm sitting here after all the rum punch. I'm like, the rum punch went down way too smooth.
They kept it.
Way too smooth.
I was going to say, they kept it flowing out there on the island.
Oh my gosh. And he just kept making more and making more. It was so good.
Yeah.
And I'm sitting here trying to go to dinner. We had like nice dinner planned in Montego Bay. And I'm like, I looked at you. I was like, babe, I need to crank this coffee up.
Yeah,
this coffee has to get cranked up, and I'm drinking coffee at like 5:30.
Yeah, he was tired, but we made it through. So.
Blue Mountain Coffee too, which is like, you know, hardcore.
Yeah,
it's really good. It's really good.
So. Yeah. So another few things I want to say about the island out there. They have also completely renovated that swim up bar, which is really nice.
Very nice.
Yeah, it's a smaller pool and a smaller bar, but you know, I think it's the perfect size for the island. And then just speaking on the and they changed the restaurant out there. Well, one of the restaurants. So it used to kind of be like a beachside grill kind of thing.
Like a grill restaurant.
Yeah, like 6 years ago, and now it's a jerk shack. So they have all the jerk chicken, jerk pork, that sort of thing. And then they still have the Thai restaurant.
Yeah, and the Thai restaurant's like their sit down, nice restaurant that's out there.
Yeah. And reservations are required for that one. Now, if you're staying in the overwater bungalows, so these overwater bungalows work a little differently than, like, say, any of the other butler options at resorts. So you have 24-hour butler service, whereas...
Oh, really?
Yes, where...
That is insane.
Yeah, as if you're, you know, in a regular butler category anywhere else, you don't have the 24-hour butler service. They also keep a chef out there on the island all night long, so you can, you know, order food, and obviously it will be delivered quickly because it's being made right there on the island and they don't have to, you know, go over to the main part of the resort.
That is awesome. Why haven't you taken me to, why don't we stay in one?
Well, I need the price. That's one reason.
Oh, okay. I figured price would be
something. Which we'll talk about. But the butler, those overwater villas also come with expedited immigration. So you get Club Mo Bay. You get the private luxury transfers and the BMW, you know, a lot of extra perks, which, I mean, you kind of should for how much money they cost. So they have bungalows and then they have villas, and there is a difference. The difference is in the size. The villas are larger, and then they have a private infinity pool on them.
Those infinity pools look amazing.
Yes.
And we're going to dive into that here in just a second. Before we do, I want to give some shout outs.
Yes.
Because we had some people hit us up while we were gone. So, Bruce, thank you so much for submitting a quote request for Capcana. We appreciate it. Secrets Capcana, Dominican Republic. Very great value property.
Yes.
Love me some Capcana. And then we have Samantha from Seattle. Thank you so much for hitting us up. She's looking for a honeymoon a couple different places, right?
Yeah. Interested in several different options.
I love a good honeymoon.
Oh, of course. Yeah. Who doesn't love to plan a honeymoon?
I mean, honeymoons are like, going on your honeymoon is so exciting.
It is so exciting.
Because... Well, you're tired, but the wedding's over. But now it's like the really fun part.
When it's your first, normally, like your, or not normally, but you know, a lot of couples splurge. You know, it's their very first like out of country trip, so it's very exciting.
Absolutely, absolutely. All right, so let's get back to the private island and the overwater bungalows.
Yes,
these pictures. So first of all, let me just say this. So I just hopped on TripAdvisor. I just want to see where the TripAdvisor rankings are. They got this one ranked number 11 in Montego Bay. Sandals Royal Caribbean, mm-hmm. number 11.
Well, that's
strongly
why...
Strongly disagree.
You also can't believe everything you strongly, see on TripAdvisor.
Strongly, strongly, strongly disagree.
And
that is
real quick,
that is just wrong.
Well, real quick, I want to mention an example of why you cannot believe everything on TripAdvisor. Not all the time. Some of them I agree with,
yeah,
some of them
fine.
I don't.
Yeah.
But remember we picked that hotel when we went to Pittsburgh and it was like the number one on TripAdvisor in downtown Pittsburgh and it really was not good.
So, oh, yeah. We
like our room was dirty.
People, it's really hard because when people do their own reviews and ratings of properties, not to say like, I mean, everyone can have an opinion, everyone does, but sometimes someone's view of something that's quote nice is not necessarily someone else's.
Oh, right. Everyone's opinions are all subjective.
It's all based on what you like.
Yeah,
really.
What you like.
So it's really hard. That's why travel is really hard when people ask for like other people's opinions on like Facebook and stuff. It's really hard because like you don't know if that person likes the same quality food you like or the same quality beverage or the same quality room. Like some people, like there's some people that like love a Days Inn. It's a great value. And there's other people that are like, no, I only want Marriott and above. Yeah, Marriott's a great value.
Or Four Seasons. Yeah.
Like value is such a relative term. But anyways, getting back to it here, I just wholeheartedly disagree that that is the number 11 in Montego Bay. But they do have some good pictures up here. But going back to the overwater bungalow, I mean, these are just, These are amazing. And I think that if you're looking for half the, not even half, probably a quarter or less of the travel time,
yeah,
but you want the overwater bungalow experience, this might be a good spend for you.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's expensive, but
certainly
it is all inclusive. So that's, you know, something separate. Like if you were to go to, let's just say, the St. Regis in Bora Bora, which is absolutely amazing, and I would highly recommend it. They have meal plans included, or like the option to add that on, but you know, no drinks are included. And then of course you're going to spend, it's an overnight flight to get there, an overnight flight home. You do get the butler service, but you know, it's, when comparing all of that, I mean, this definitely is, you know, a great value for considering what you get for half the travel time.
Yeah. We're gonna have to do a whole podcast episode, I think, now on, the value of the overwater bungalows in the Caribbean versus overwater bungalows in Bora Bora. I think that would be a very, very interesting episode. And I think you got the price, so we might as well run a little pricing comparison right now.
Yeah, so these overwater bungalows at the Sandals Royal Caribbean, the availability can be hard to find. I mean, they are pretty much sold out. I mean, there is some availability in February and March, just because I think, you know, some people have canceled last minute. But pretty much after that, the only time that I could find 7 full nights available was December. And so this pricing is based, or no, I'm sorry, this was January. So this pricing is based on January 2022. And for 7 nights, it's $17,975. For 7 nights, no, you know, airfare or anything like that. So for comparison purposes, the St. Regis in Bora Bora, which if you travel a lot, I'm not saying that St. Regis and Sandals are on the same level.
Yeah, we're just comparing. I'm just comparing overwater bungalows.
Yes,
yeah, 100%.
I just want to make that disclaimer. Like, I know that St. Regis is better than Sandals.
It's a way more exotic, secluded, and also the destinations the are different, and the brand.
The brand name. Yeah. Yes, it. I mean, it is. It is what it is. It's way more fancy.
But these overwater bungalows are kind of hard to find, so that's why we're comparing it.
Yes. So just to give you an idea on the price, so with a meal plan, so they don't have the all-inclusive option, so you would have to pay for your drinks, which, I mean, when you're there, the drinks are expensive, so you're going to have to be prepared for that.
Yeah, it's a cap. They know they've got the captive audience. You're right. Not going to leave. There's nowhere really to go.
Right, yeah. So $17,403 at the St. Regis in their least expensive overwater. So this does not have a pool or anything like that.
Okay,
so.
And what was Jamaica?
$17,975.
Okay, so they've got them priced pretty close.
Right.
Jamaica includes all your food and drinks.
Right.
The other one obviously doesn't, but they do have a package, you said.
No, that one includes all of your meals.
Oh, it does, all your meals.
Yeah, just not your drinks. Alcohol.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
It's interesting. I mean, you've stayed. I mean, you've been in both of them, so you could probably. I mean, yeah, I don't want this to get too side railed on overwater bungalows.
No, it's not. It's just, I mean, you know, I say, hey, if you got the money, try both one day.
Try them both. Yeah. You know? I mean, the water is still pretty blue in Jamaica.
Yeah. There's something to be said, you know, for way less travel time. I mean, some people just have absolutely no desire for that long of a flight to and travel time for Bora Bora, you know.
Yeah,
and
if
you only have 7 nights, you know, you have to factor in that you're going to also spend 2 more nights traveling, you know, for Bora Bora. So,
yeah.
You know, it all just kind of depends on, you know, your time, what you're looking for, and that sort of thing. But that's a good price comparison.
Yep. And no, I agree. And it's very interesting that I thought there would have been a little bit more of a difference, but obviously one includes your beverages, one doesn't. So, yeah. And obviously we're not comparing flight time or flight price.
Yes.
So, anyways. Okay. Good to know.
Yes.
Good to know.
Now, talking a little bit more on the rooms, just because, you know, we talked about how much they've done to update.
Hey, before we move on to the rooms.
This resort. Oh, okay. What are we doing?
Do we have to mention there's another piece to the private island.
Oh, yeah. If you like to sunbathe naked, then
there's a nude beach.
There's a nude beach.
It's on the backside that no one can really, obviously you can't see unless you go.
Right.
We didn't go.
George had a lot of rum punch. You thought about it.
I had a little liquid confidence. I was like, hey, I might as well. Like, this would be great to put on the podcast. Talk about this.
Yeah. He did not.
No, I just, even after 10.
10 rum punches.
I don't think I had 10, but even after like 4 or 5, I was
kind of
like,
I think it was about 10.
There's no way it was 10.
Okay, maybe 8.
Okay, I'll give you six.
But, you know, there are people, yeah, you know, if you like to do that.
It's certainly an option.
It is an option. I have a client recently who told me that they had never tried that before, and they just wanted to try it.
Yeah, like, for sure.
They love it, and they're going back.
I think there's a higher percentage of the population that would do it than we'd probably believe.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I bet that number is a little higher than I would think. I would think it'd be a low number. I bet it would come back higher than I think.
Yeah, no, I think it would.
After a couple of drinks, I was like, heck, I might as well give it a try. Everyone's doing it.
He said it's just something so free about being, naked out there in public. Well, you know, you're in Jamaica. Nobody knows you. So
I wouldn't want a sunburn downstairs.
All right, well, if I get a sunburn down there,
that is not good.
Yeah, that would not be good, but let's not talk about that.
No. So, I'd have to put sunscreen on down there. I've never done that before.
Yeah, all right. So rooms.
My butt cheeks are really white, though, so I'm sure
every man is that doesn't sunbathe naked.
I know. I probably wouldn't put sunscreen on that. Actually, no, they would burn easier.
Yeah,
then.
They would. It would burn really bad.
Yeah.
All right,
how do they do it?
I don't know. Let's move on, please. So they have redone a lot of the resort. A lot of the rooms are updated at this resort. And one that was recently renovated, one section that I'm really excited about, is the Caribbean Poolside Village. So as you're pulling up to the resort, it's like right there on the left. And these are some very affordable rooms that they have completely redone. They're in a great location, quiet part of the resort. You have a pool right there. They have redone the whole inside of them. They look super modern. And then they've also added the soaking tubs on the patio and the balcony, which, you know, everybody loves that. So
I do. Yeah, I love those. I mean, because you use them. And when you get back, you know, when you get back to your room after a day at the beach or the pool.
Yeah.
And sometimes it feels good just getting some hot water and just do it on your balcony. Just go out there on the balcony, get in the hot water. I'll leave my bathing suit on and just sit out there with a drink and kick my feet up, let the breeze come in.
Yeah, and so for 7 nights, you can get in there and this is just in October, $35.30 for 7 nights, all inclusive stay. And then there is a room category below that, the two of them that are a little bit less expensive, the Caribbean Deluxe, but it's only a $200 savings if you were to do that. And I think, you know, for $200 for 7 nights, and you're getting a much nicer room, much more outdoor space. You know, I would definitely do that. I think it's worth it.
Yeah. And a lot of Sandals are starting to put a lot of these tubs on their balconies and patios. Like as they renovate rooms, I've noticed that's like a thing that they're doing.
Yeah. A lot of people like that.
And I mean, I get in them with my bathing suit on. I'm sure a lot of people, if you want to go naked, you could, but there are curtains to close.
Is naked the theme of this podcast
now? I guess. I'm just letting everyone know, if you want to do that, you can actually close curtains, privacy curtains on your balcony.
Yes, so there are privacy curtains on your patio and balcony. So if you wanted to do that, you could.
Yeah, I'm on.
So now they've also added a couple of restaurants at this resort. They added the Bombay Club, which that's their Indian cuisine restaurant. So they've added that. So there's a total of 9 restaurants at Sandals Royal Caribbean. And then if you include everything at Sandals Montego Bay, it gives you 21 total dining options, which is awesome.
Yeah, and I think if you're considering either resort, like if you're looking at either one of them, consider that you have it's a really big deal for those that haven't been to either of these properties that you have access to the other one. And it's very convenient.
Yeah.
I understand, like, other resorts say, oh, well, you have access to our sister property, it's 25 minutes away. No one likes to do that.
Right.
When it's right next to each other, it's really great because you get the benefit of both. You really do. It's simple. It's convenient. The van's running every hour. I mean, it's super
Which
easy.
It's different here than the 3 resorts in St. Lucia that share exchange privileges, because those are, like, the furthest ones can be 30 minutes apart.
Yeah.
And so that shuttle only runs every 2 hours. But here in Jamaica, it's every hour because it's 5 minutes down the road. Now, one other thing I want to mention with this resort, with Sandals Royal Caribbean, is it is in Montego Bay, so you do have the plane noise, but it's a different plane noise. So at Sandals Montego Bay, you're literally right next to the runway, so you hear the planes taking off, and then the way that the planes kind of go, then they go over Royal Caribbean. So you do hear them going overhead, but I mean, you get used to it. It's very minimal, too.
It's very minimal,
and I feel like you get used to it. You don't even hear it after a day.
Yeah, I mean,
no matter which one you're at.
Again, I think we said on our last podcast, this isn't like Atlanta or Chicago or, you know, LaGuardia. Like, these planes are not very frequent. They're
right.
There's and they don't, they certainly don't go overnight too. So something to think about. But I mean, I just think having what changed the game also for me on Royal Caribbean is having access now to the Montego Bay restaurants, the new Montego Bay restaurants. So
yeah.
When I say new Montego Bay at Sandals, I'm talking about the soy they added.
Yes.
And Butch's Steakhouse.
Right.
That is a huge addition for me. That's just for me because I like steak and I like sushi.
Yeah.
And they don't have those at Royal Caribbean, but I can hop on the van and in 5 minutes I'm there.
Oh, yeah. So you literally have a wide variety of dining options to choose from.
I love that. And see, I think that combined with having that private island, because out there at the private island, we stayed at Montego Bay and we just did the day trip to Royal Caribbean. If we were to stay at Royal Caribbean, I would spend a large amount of time on the private island.
Yes.
You feel very secluded. There's a nice breeze out there because you have the big water coming in. There's always a good breeze.
Oh, and that
out
bar
there.
Out there is open until 10 p.m. So if you are, I don't remember if I said this earlier or not, but if you are staying in the overwater bungalows too, that's a nice perk because if you don't want to just hang out in your room, then yeah, you have that option.
Yeah, and the bartender that was there, I don't know if he's there every time, but he was there for over 20 years.
Yeah, he's been there since 1996, I think.
He's got the history on the whole place. Because when I walked in, but we got on the island. I was like, this has been renovated, hasn't it? And he goes, oh, yeah. And he starts telling us all about it.
Yeah.
So it was really cool. And, you know, the bartenders are friendly. You get to know them. I've got a cool picture of them on the video coming out soon.
Another few things I want to mention about Sandals Royal Caribbean is if you're also looking for a resort that is very easy to walk around, this is definitely a great option. And I think it's a better option than Sandals Montego Bay, depending on, you know, what kind of room you want, really. But
yeah.
Sandals Montego Bay is very spread out all along the beach. Sandals Royal Caribbean is very, like, just kind of closed in.
Yeah.
And I mean that in a good way. Like, it feels like you're in, like I love, like, the village feel, and you kind of just feel like that when you're there. And everything is, you know, you can easily walk around the whole resort, like, in 5 minutes.
Yeah, very walkable.
Unless you're going to the island, obviously, but...
Yeah, and it does have that village feel because a lot of the restaurants are very central.
Yep.
Most of them are. Obviously not the private island restaurant
right.
out there. But, you know, it's I don't know, everything combined when we talk about this, I'm like, this thing has just shot up in my rankings.
Yeah, and overall vibe of it is, you know, I think it has a really good mix of, you know, liveliness. And if you want, you know, the quiet area to just lounge on the beach or the pool, it's perfect for that too. So I think it is good for any traveler.
Yeah, and they had the Bob Marley playing out there. I mean, the vibes could not have been better out there on that private island.
Well, and the whole resort.
The whole resort, too.
I think it has, you know, something for everyone. If you're looking for peace and quiet and laid back and relaxed, yeah, you can go out to the island. Or if you want a lot of action, the main swim up pool bar, you know, on the mainland is great. It's hopping.
Yeah.
So I think it has something for everyone.
And on average, this prices out it's a little less expensive than Montego Bay.
Yes, it usually does price out a little bit less expensive.
So that's something else to think about. I mean, and no, now when you think about the beach, so if we're, I don't want to get into a big comparison here, but the beach isn't as wide and beautiful and big as you have in Montego Bay. It's
right.
going to be a little bit of a smaller beach. So you're sacrificing a little bit there. For our personalities, again, for those that have followed the show for a long time, we love beaches, but we're just more pool people.
Yeah.
Like, we lounge on the beach. We hung out on the beach in Montego Bay. But, you know, having a smaller beach isn't going to make or break my trip.
Right.
So, you know, going forward, it's like, I mean, our next time Montego Bay, obviously we're going to stay at Royal Caribbean because we just did Montego Bay. But it's something to think about if you're comparing the two. The beach. If you're a big beach person,
yes.
that might be the deal breaker. And hey, head over, enjoy the private island and everything Royal Caribbean has.
Yeah.
So I don't know. It was fun. It was fun. I can't wait to get the video out. And
hopefully quicker than the Le Blanc one.
And I can't wait to go back.
Yes.
Can't wait to go back.
Yeah, I cannot wait to go back. We left 2 days before they were starting up the new requirements for COVID testing before you return back to the States. So, you know, we did kind of get a little bit of information on that. They're doing it in a kind of like a central room located on the resort is where they're doing the testing. And then you get your test within 24 hours.
Yeah. The news is like flooded right now with like what the new requirements are for, and they're all talking about every island implementing this, every resort implementing this. So the news is really heavy right now with how these resorts are handling it.
Well, not every, I mean, every island has to implement it because
that's what I'm saying. Yeah, but it's say, like
it's a new requirement for all international air travelers.
There's like more specifics coming out now about how Sandals is going to do it and how Secrets is going to do it and how this resort is going to do it. And, you know, it's just, it's interesting to see how this all is going to kind of play out. And
Sandals is complimentary, the testing. They are providing it complimentary. And then if you do test positive, this is one thing I want to mention, and you're required to quarantine there for 2 weeks. So they charge a compassion rate, $200 per person per night. And so you would be required to pay that. And then with the complimentary insurance that they provide you,
you get reimbursed.
You could then be reimbursed for that. That is the latest on that. I don't know if they're going to end up seeking reimbursement, but that's how it's been explained to me in the last few days. So you'd have to be prepared for that.
Yeah, more to come on that because that's a ever evolving thing. Yes. Like that, I could see that
as
changing.
Of January 27th. That is what it is.
I could literally see in a couple of days news breaking on that changing. So more to come on that.
Yeah.
We just don't know. They haven't even started the new thing yet, so it's hard to say. But
I haven't heard of anyone, you know, testing positive yet. So
yeah. So, but anyways, I think that might be. Anything else you want to add about Royal Caribbean?
No, I think that's it for Royal Caribbean trip of the week.
What is your trip of the week
besides ours from last week?
Trip of the week is
I do have someone, which I am happy to report, did not cancel their trip. They are headed to Hard Rock in Cabo on Saturday.
Ooh, and speaking of Hard Rock Cabo, I might be going to a bachelor party in Hard Rock Punta Cana.
Yes, yeah,
great resorts.
Yeah,
great resorts.
Definitely. What's your question of the day now?
Question of the day. I need to get some audio that does that for me.
Yeah, I think you do.
Yeah. Okay. What snack can you just not get enough of?
Chips and salsa.
Oh, that was quick. You shot from the hip there.
I mean, that's like a good snack, right?
Yeah, that's a good one.
I mean, I love chips and salsa.
Yeah, chips and salsa is up there for me. You got to think about the ones that are just so craveable, you could just continue to, you know, gorge yourself until you explode and it goes everywhere. I think
yeah, that would be chips and salsa for me.
Yeah, that might be it for me. What are those chips we've been buying lately? The early July?
Yeah, something like
that. Or late June or late July?
Late July. It's some brand. I don't know. I know where they are in the grocery store. I don't remember the name.
It's like the organic, like, you know, flaxseed stuff. Anyways, those are delicious.
Well, I really like the thin and crispy cantina kind with Tostitos, but they're not the best for you, so I don't buy them.
Yeah, we're at least, if we're going to eat chips, we're going to try to go a little healthier. But like that green bag, whatever the flavor is, I just know the green bag's the best one.
Yeah.
Those probably are completely, I guess, is binge-worthy good? Is that a good term for just shoving chips down your throat?
I mean, you tend to eat the whole bag once it's open, so. Yeah.
I do, because there'll be a full bag, and then you'll wake up the next day and be like, where's the bag of chips? Be like, oh,
I think you finished the bag that I opened at lunch today.
Oh, man, I did.
Yeah, see, I told you.
They're so good. Yeah. You opened the green bag.
Well, I noticed that the chip clip was sitting on the kitchen counter earlier, and so I was like, he must have finished the bag.
The chip clip, yep. So no need for a chip clip when the bag's empty.
Yeah, that's
so
right.
It's in the trash, and they were delicious.
All right, well, I think that's a show.
That is a
if
show.
If you want more information on anything you heard today, if you would like a quote, please feel free to reach out. You can reach us 1-800-674-3278, or if you go to our website, pinyactravel.com, and click request a quote, it comes directly to me, or you can slide into our DMs on Facebook or Instagram. One last thing to mention, and I feel like I don't mention this enough on the podcast, but if you are thinking about Sandals Royal Caribbean and you are military, police, firefighter, or FEMA worker, you get 10% off the prices.
Yeah, that's really good. We got to mention that more often.
Yes.
We're going to put all the ways to connect with us in the show notes. And I forgot, we do have a 5-star review I want to give a shout out to. Instagram Lover on Apple gave us a 5-star review. Thank you so much. And they said, while it is a bit of a turnoff that they are asking specifically for 5-star reviews rather than just asking for reviews, I am enjoying the podcast. I've learned a lot, and the podcast gets me excited about future travel. Well, thank you for the 5-star review.
Whenever I really appreciate it.
Whenever I do ask, I feel like, please give us a review. A 5-star would be great. I mean, you know, maybe I shouldn't say that. I don't know. I don't think it sounds bad.
Well, I mean, you know, if you're going to give us a one star, I'd rather you not review it.
Yeah, like, don't give us a one star. Like, it's funny because, like, I guess because we don't run ads on this, we kind of do this on our own. Like, there's no, we don't monetize this anyway. We don't want to, at least as of right now, we're not going to put ads on here at all. And so, you know, the algorithms are weird on Apple. The only way you get distribution, the way people find you, is if you have, like, five-star reviews. That's, like, that's the algorithm that they use. And so, you know, we love any reviews. Don't get me wrong. And I must say, I'm sorry, selfishly, I kind of prefer five stars.
Yeah, we kind of prefer five stars.
I love five stars. But, you know, again, any review.
We appreciate any review.
Any feedback's good feedback.
Yes.
Anyways, but we love you. Thank you so much. We're super grateful for that review. We really appreciate it. And we appreciate all our reviews and everyone listening to us. By the way, we were ranking in the top 100 in Apple.
Yeah.
Which is unbelievable.
Yes.
And we'd been up there earlier, and then it kind of trickled off a little bit because the pandemic's changed people's listening behaviors. But while we were gone, actually, we looked at the ratings, and we were in the crack the top 100 again, which felt really freaking good.
Yeah, that's
actually
cool.
Like number 40-something, I think.
Yeah.
And that felt good. I got to look. They change like every hour. But anyways, that is a testament to you guys. Thank you guys so much. We love it. We appreciate it.
One more shout out, Sydney on Facebook.
Oh, yeah, Sydney.
Sliding into our DMs.
Thank you, Sydney.
Yeah, thank you for listening.
We hear from her a lot. Sydney's a rock star.
Yeah.
Thank you, Sydney. Yeah, we appreciate it. And yeah, we are going to crank up the frequency. She was commenting on, you know, she'd heard that we're going to crank this up a little bit. We're probably at 2.5 a week. We're going to get to 3. And we're going to keep the content coming.
So I don't know how you do 2.5 a week, but okay.
Well, if you were to average probably our shows over the last little bit, I don't know. But anyways, this thing's been fun. We're going to keep it going. Love hearing from you guys. Love the interaction. Thank you so much, Sydney. We love you guys. We will see you.
Catch you next time.
Next time.